Hello guys, welcome to Viha Forest. I hope you all are doing good. In this video, I'm going to explain you about polymorphism concept in Java. So basically, polymorphism is one of the key component for which belongs to OOPS concepts, object-oriented programming syndrome. So yeah, polymorphism is nothing but existing in more than one forms. It may be a method, or it may be an operator. So there are two types of polymorphism in Java: compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. And runtime polymorphism is also called as dynamic method dispatch. So first let's see compile time polymorphism. And method overloading is perfect example for compile time polymorphism. So here I have created one class named addition, and inside which we have a method named sum, which accepts integer a and integer b, two parameters, or we can say arguments. This particular method sum will accept two arguments into it, and inside which I have written an operation addition, and the value performed will be stored in x, which will be printed using system.out.println. And at the same time, I have created one more method. I have created one more method with the same name sum, but here I have added three arguments. So when there are two different, when there are two methods which are present with same name, but the type of arguments are different. It may be the data type of arguments may be different, or the number of arguments may be different. So here I am trying to add one more argument int c. So I am trying to perform addition operation between three arguments, and I am storing it in the variable y. And the next line I am trying to print the value of y. And this is nothing but method overloading. So I will explain the execution part later on. So when it comes to runtime polymorphism, which is also called as dynamic method dispatch, method overriding is perfect example for runtime polymorphism. Here you can see I have created one more class color, and which contains a method color. I'm trying to print color class inside a color method. And in 34th line, you can see I have created one more class named blue, which extends color class. This is the concept of inheritance, and inside which I am trying to override color method, which belongs to color class. So inheritance provides that feature, like we can override all the existing methods of parent class. So here color is parent class and blue is child class. In technical terms, we can call color as a base class and blue as derived class. So I am trying to print blue color in this overridden method. So next, for the execution purpose, I have created one more class named polymorphism example, and public static void main string args, where the execution gets started. And inside which I have created one object for addition class. So when the control comes to a dot sum of 1 to, which is 46th line, it will directly go to the class addition and the method sum. And I have passed two parameters, 1, 2. So this particular method holds those values, integer a and integer b. So a and b will hold the values of 1 and 2. Inside, the addition operation between a and b will be performed, and the value will be stored in x, and it will print the value of x. Okay, and here I am trying to call the method sum with three arguments, 1, 2, 3. And when the control comes to 47th line, it will go to 17th line sum method, which accepts three parameters, or we can say arguments, and 1, 2, 3. Inside I'm trying to perform addition operation between the three parameters and trying to store the particular value into y, and here the value of y will be printed over here. So when we try to execute, here you can see value of x to be 3 and value of y to be 6. Value of x to be 3. So 1 plus 2 will be 3 and the value will be printed over here. And 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is 6, and the value will be printed over here. This is nothing but method overloading concept, which is also called as compile time polymorphism. Then after, I'm trying to print this just to differentiate between both compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. Then after, here you can see color C equal to new color. I'm trying to create an object for color class. And I'm trying to call this method color, which belongs to parent class. So it will print color class. Then after, here I'm trying to create one more object for blue class. At the same time, I'm trying to print, call color class, which belongs to derived class, which is blue. So here it will print blue color. When we see in the console, it will print color class, then after blue color. It is because of runtime polymorphism, which is also called as dynamic method dispatch. So the name of methods here will be same, but the functionality inside it holds is different. This is called as runtime polymorphism, which means that existing in more than one forms. In the same time, compile time polymorphism, here you can see the name of methods will be same, but the number of arguments it accepts are different, or the type of arguments it accepts will be different. These are the scenarios of compile time polymorphism. I hope you understood about what is polymorphism and what are the different types of polymorphism with an example. I hope it's informative to you. So do like, share, comment, and subscribe to Vyuha 4S for more interesting content, guys. See you all in my next video. Take care.